Hello guys and welcome back to a new video. Today I will explain you the difference between mild hybrid, hybrid and plug-in hybrid. So at the end of this video, you will know everything about these three versions. I don't know if you know this, but at the moment the auto industry is in a transition period, a transition that want to eliminate petrol and diesel as a source of energy for cars. In the last years, automakers make very big efforts and invest millions of dollars to lower the CO2 emission for their cars. They also build new factory and facilities to create new platforms for electric cars. The reason why they are in such a rush is because the government raised the taxes for every CO2 gram that the car emit. What this mean? That simply mean manufacturer will pay zero taxes if the car will emit zero CO2. The less CO2 emission, the less taxes for manufacturers. Now that we know the reason why we see more and more hybrid cars, let's talk about all three versions. First of all, we go to the mild hybrid system. The car that are powered with mild hybrid system have an internal combustion engine, diesel or petrol, and an electric motor and a separate special battery. Now, the difference is that mild hybrid system use a much smaller electric motor. It's more like a starter and also a smaller battery between 0.1 and 0.8 kilowatt hour. The electric motor and the battery cannot power itself the car. This is something to keep in mind on the mild hybrid cars. Without the combustion engine, the car will not move. So the only reason the system is there is to help the internal combustion during acceleration and coasting. Because the combustion engine will be assisted at acceleration, you will have also a smoother ride and some extra torque. The engine can sometimes switch off in order to save fuel and reduce CO2 emission. The main benefit and purpose of the system are to reduce CO2 emission and save more fuel. Also, it will give the car extra power, but in a very small amount, maximum 5%. Now, the advantages of the mild hybrid system are lower emission, reduced running cost, smoother ride, and also lower purchase cost. The disadvantages are more mechanical pieces that need to be changed in case of failure. Now, let's go to the second one, hybrid system. Now that we know what is mild hybrid system, let's go to the hybrid system. We start by telling you that hybrid system use a bigger battery than the mild hybrid system and also a much bigger motor or motors. Yes, you hear well, motors, because some hybrid cars can have even two electric motors combined with the internal combustion engine. Also, hybrid cars can be powered only by electric motors and some of them can reach speed of 130 km only in electric mode. Here depend on the battery charging status, road condition and other elements. Because of the bigger battery and bigger electric motor, the car will have more horsepower and torque. Also will experience more often the smooth and silent ride which you can find all the time in electric cars. Not only the fuel saving and fewer CO2 emission are an advantages, but also the internal combustion engine and electric motor will work together to give you the maximum power. Something to remember about hybrid system is that the hybrid car cannot be charged. They will charge automatically when the car will brake, go downhill, or also it will charge by the combustion engine when the car is running. Most of the car manufacturers will offer in the cars different driving modes depending on your preference and road condition. The hybrid system advantages: lower CO2 emissions, smooth and silent ride when in electric mode, better fuel economy, lower taxes, and of course it has some disadvantages like bigger price, more mechanical piece that need to be changed in case of failure, the same as the mild hybrid system. Now let's go to the third one, my favorite, it's plug-in hybrid system. plug-in hybrid cars have a much bigger battery, usually between 13 and 18 kilowatt hour. Great part is that you can charge the car to a cable. So not only that, the battery will be recharged as you drive like the hybrid system, but you can also plug in the cable in the car and charge it at home or at a fast public charging station. When it comes to charging speed, all plug-in hybrid cars can be charged at a normal wall socket that we have all in our homes. Of course, the charging time will be much longer than on a special wall box or a public fast charging station, but it's an option. In a plug-in hybrid cars, you will also have an electric only range that varies between 25 and 75 kilometers depending on the battery size and the car model. The great part is that you can have both worlds in a single car. You will have a combustion engine and an electric motor that give you the possibility to feel both experience. In the city, you can drive 100% electric, and on the highway, as long trips, you can use the combustion engine. So that's a great advantage in my opinion. Also, plug-in hybrid cars will give you a better total range than electric cars or classic IC cars. Another big advantage is that plug-in hybrid will benefit from better tax incentives, so you will pay fewer yearly taxes. Depending in which country you are, you can benefit from big governmental discount when you are buying the car for the first time. Plug-in hybrid advantages, of course, the same as the other one: lower CO2 emission, possibility to charge the car with a cable, smooth and silent ride when in electric mode, better fuel economy, lower taxes, hold the value in time better, and also it has some disadvantage, of course, bigger price, more mechanical pieces that need to be changed in case of failure, and if you drive with an empty battery, the car weight will make the combustion engine to work more, so in conclusion, to consume more fuel. So now that you know the difference between all three versions, you can make a better decision when you will buy your next car. I hope the video was helpful, and if you have questions, guys, just write me down below, ask me wherever you want, I will answer to you with pleasure. I read all your comments. Please don't forget to subscribe, like and share my video, that will mean a lot for me. Also, thank you very much to all my subscribers, to all of you guys, I really appreciate that you are watching my video. I'm really, really happy to help you with all the questions that you have. Also, don't forget to check out our website, sda-car.com. There you find a lot of information, a lot of tips about cars, videos, auto industry, and all kind of stuff. Also, subscribe to see the newest car that will come on my channel. Thank you very much. I await your feedbacks about this video. If you want to see more of those kind of videos, I'm really happy to do it for you. So just write me down below and tell me. Until next time, stay safe and see you soon.